And once again, welcome back. Blessing Health System President and CEO Maureen Khan, continuing to answer your questions about coronavirus. Of course, here in our studios, we have an email, of course, from Joyce. But before we get to that, I want to ask you, this is an unprecedented medical emergency that we've had. How are you and your staff at Blessing dealing with this, and questions from the public? What's that been like for you?
Oh, this has been like a real roller coaster ride for me and for my staff, because there isn't a playbook for this. We have, drills for tornadoes. We've got drills for all kinds of disasters, but this has been a new one. And every day, from the CDC to IDPH to the World Health Organization, we're getting new information. And I have to tell you, this community is blessed with great physicians who work here, great care providers, staff, and I've got great technicians, whether they be maintenance engineers or nurses at the bedside, who, when we say we need to do this or we need to make this change, they were able to do it. So I think this community is very, very fortunate, because they've got a lot of great providers who we are all working together. Blessing, QMG, SIU. We are working as a team to make sure that we keep this community healthy and safe.
All right, that's what's going to take, a team effort, no doubt about that. Of course, let's go to Joyce Fairley's email now. She wants to know, how many people have they tested for the virus, if they have those results back yet, and if anyone has tested positive?
Well, Joyce, I can let you know that no one has tested positive as of today. We have tested 20 people in our community, and we know of 4 negative results as of this point in time. So no positive results as of today.
And again, we want to talk about the hand washing, how important that is. People laugh about the suggestions, but it's saving lives.
It is saving lives. I mean, we can't wash our hands enough. And, you know, we say get your favorite song so that you're there and you can sing that song while you're washing your hands. We talk about social distancing. And, you know, you see it now today in lines,
in
meetings.
We're practicing
it tonight. But you want to make sure that you keep that little 6 feet away. And we do the elbow bump instead of shaking hands. And you want to think about everything you do. Keep your hands away from your face. Don't touch it. Don't touch your eyes. Because today, our hands are touching so many surfaces. And as much as we try and keep them clean, we don't know what's happening. You know, a lot of folks in the community are saying, why does it take so long to get test results back? Well, you know, the commercial labs today are taking about 6 days to get our test results back.
And on the cusp of that, let me get this message in for Corinne, a follow-up to Joyce's email in the time that we have left. She thinks that people have a false sense of security that our virus is, that the virus is not in our area, because no positive test results have been announced yet. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, I think because we haven't done enough testing yet, because we can only test those individuals who meet the CDC's guidelines or the IDPH guidelines, because there are limited amount of tests available. We've got a couple hundred test kits available, but we can only use them on individuals who meet the criteria for the test right now. And so that's part of the limitation. And why we set up those screening sites, which we have out at 28th and Chestnut and at the hospital, because we're asking people, if they think they have flu-like symptoms, we want to look at them a little closer to see if they may meet the criteria to at least do a test.
That's very important.
Mm-hmm.
Vital, in fact. And quite, Jamie West Hall wants to know, how long does the virus live on surfaces if it goes without care and not being disinfected properly? How long does it live?
You know, I wish I could tell them, because we get different information every day. And the CDC is really learning a lot more about this virus, because it may vary based on the surface, the temperature of the room, the type of material. So I'm not the expert to tell them that, and they're still learning about this virus.
We all are. We all are, no doubt about that. That's our time for this broadcast, but our conversation continues until 7 p.m. over on WGM News Talk 105. Keep your questions coming either on social media or to news@WGEM.com. Maureen, thanks for joining us. We'll see you on the radio side.
I'm Tony Cornish Jr. Thank you very much for having me.
Yeah, I'm Tony Cornish Jr. Have a safe night. We'll see you at 10 o'clock.